Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Vincex Manny, or L, as most people call me. Welcome to my channel. This video right here is going to be a reaction video to the Cowboy Bebop Netflix live action that's come out within the past week. Today, about 8 hours ago, the actual session one trailer was released, but I'm going to be watching the first session zero and the season one trailer at the same time. Personally, I've had my ifs about, like, I wasn't too sure about Cowboy Bebop's live action. I've never really liked live actions myself, but I mean, being a big Cowboy Bebop fan, I want to check it out, you know? I'm going to be making a few points that I'm going to be skeptical about. To be honest, I'm a diehard fan. I really love the anime so much. It was the first anime I ever watched back in 2002. I'm 30 years old now, so this tells you how long ago that was. And I guess just like many other people who grew up watching Cowboy Bebop, I've watched it so many times over the years, they're gonna have the same kind of feeling as I am. I saw what was going on in the trailers. I've seen it already, but I'm gonna do a double take. I saw what was going on, and honestly, I don't know. I'm not really excited, super excited by it. We'll see how it goes. But yeah, we're gonna pull up the first trailer right now, and we're going to just take a look at that, and I'm gonna take little, you know, I'm gonna throw little notes out there and stuff. So here's my background. The swordfish, always got that as a background. Okay, so I've got the first one right here. Let's go. So it might be a bit too loud, I'm sorry.
Hey, there's a new bounty on the line.
Worth the trouble?
You want to keep the lights on around here?
Where did we find this dipstick?
We'll handle this one.
On our own.
Not a chance.
Not that way! Bang! The bounty.
I got him.
That's not the bounty either.
What the?
Spike!
What?
We're on a job.
Seriously?
Noodles first.
Hello, Spike.
This way.
Oh, bad guy!
Hey, I was gonna eat that.
Hey, Spike! A little help?
You're dead, Cowboy! That's it.
If you shoot him in the face.
That was him.
Please.
I got him with 3 clean slugs in the leg.
I never miss, and I aim for his leg.
You never miss?
Never.
You aim for the face.
I did not. You
That's
clearly
why he doesn't
got him.
Have a face.
Okay, so first of all, I'm not gonna lie, I did like the trailer, but there were some few things that really stuck out to me that I felt was necessary to be looked at. So one of the main things right here, I'm just gonna mute this, I'm just gonna run it back. One of the main things that I didn't like was the fact that Spike here, if people don't know, Spike was actually designed after, I can't remember the actor's name, you know, fucking hell. There's an actor who played in an old series back in 1979 called Tenteri Monogatari. Basically, it's like a detective show. And this guy was super cool and all that shit. And he was like, that's who Spike was basically put over. Like, he was designed after this guy. Another person, or it's more of a fictional character, that was created and Spike was like kind of showing off of, was Lupin the Third. Some people don't know that. Lupin the Third, his boots are one of the main things that is basically part of Spike's design. Now, Spike here has these normal kind of just dress shoes on, and his pants are like close to his ankles. Everyone knows that Spike doesn't have those kind of long length kind of, you know, trousers. I'm making small pics here. I know you're going to be thinking, what the fuck? This guy, what's he talking about? These are some small things here. I'm just making details. I'm just making observations from what I see. Like I'm saying, I'm a diehard fan. I like these things. Attention to details, nice with the suit. The suit looks amazing, but these shoes and the trousers, it just, for some reason, just doesn't work to me. It's the same with Faye. I'm guessing she couldn't really move around too well in what she normally wears in the anime, so they fixed it up. I think that's what I read in an article, like, a couple of months back. But, I mean, this one was hella beautiful. She does well what she's wearing, sure, but Faye's supposed to be a really, like, sexualized character. And I think she uses her sexuality to kind of, you know, get the upper hand sometimes. I mean, it could work. We don't know how it looks yet. Not too sure about the CGI here, though. And then again, it's just a teaser trailer, this one here. So I like the fact that she's got a Glock in her hand. She uses a Glock. I noticed that Spike over here uses Jericho 941. I really like that gun. Like, I actually have a replica myself. It's a BB gun, actually, so let me show you guys. Oh, shit. I actually have a replica of the Jericho. Right here. Look at that shit. Woo. Amazing. Just to show you, it's a BB gun. Got BB bullets, you know. But yeah, it's really nice. I like that shit. I noticed that they use it in the freaking... I noticed they use it in the trailer. I like that. I like the way it looks. However, the one thing I'm really surprised is why they didn't keep Jet's basic, what is it, a water? Water? Oh, what is the gun he uses? Let's check what gun he uses. So, the gun that Spike uses is Jericho 941R. His one is modified. It's got custom grip and a laser sight on the side. Like, yeah, this one. This is the one he has. This is like the standard Israeli one. And then you got the Wolfer P99, which is a standard issue police model gun that he kept since his days in the ISSP. And then, yeah, you got Faye's Glock Faye, just a natural Glock Faye. But in this, for some reason, he's got some massive-ass fucking revolver. I don't think they show it that well here. I know I saw it at one point. I'm going to try and find it later. But he has some mad crazies. He has some mad fat-ass gun, bro. I'm like, why does this guy need that big of a gun? That's not what he uses. Anyway, just a small attentions. Another thing that I was really surprised about is I like the fact they use kind of Wing Chun here, but this weird kick, that was super strange to me. Like, they've never shown Spike ever do that in the anime, ever. I don't think he's ever done a flip or some kind of kick like that. Spike is a master of Jeet Kune Do and French boxing. So why would they go through so much effort? Like, why would they add all that? Maybe it's just to more appealing to people who are watching it. They wanted something flashy, but I just felt like it was a bit over the top. It was unnecessary. And I have never, ever seen Spike say that he doesn't want to do a bounty or food. I mean, I remember, was it episode 2? Where he was trying to get Peking duck. They haven't got no money. So he was like, let me go and get this bounty and maybe I can get a Peking duck. I think that's what he said.
Even if I overhaul this whole ship, I'll still have cash left over. At least enough for, let's say, some Peking duck.
Normally he would, like, you know, he tries to get bounties before food. So that was very surprising. And, well, I guess in the first episode as well, he actually did steal that lady's baguette and put the whole thing in his mouth.
Excuse me.
Hmm? For a hot dog.
But yeah, at the end of the day, I've never heard him say noodles first. This bit right here is a bit too serious for my liking. But overall, I feel like, what's this actor's name? John, what's his name? John Cho. I feel like his portrayal of Spike is just a bit too serious. Like, Spike is more laid back. And in this, from what I can see, it's just very, very serious. Like, he just seems really serious. I don't know. Anyway, we're moving on to the next one now. Let's move on to the next. To the next trailer. Okay. Here we go.
So what brings you back from the dead?
A week ago, I did a job. A bounty. I had a partner, believe it or not.
He know what you used to be? Will I ever see you again?
They tried to kill me, Anna.
Anna, isn't that obese white lady? Or Asian, I don't know. No, I think she was adopted. They show her at one point and she owns like a convenience store. I think that's the same woman. Anyway, I'm gonna shop and I'm gonna run it back later. Sorry, apologies.
If you need to find me, I go by Spike Spiegel these days. Solar system. If the cops and the bounty hunters don't get you, the syndicate will. There's no happy ending here.
Spoken like a man who's never been in love.
I was.
What happened?
I was dreaming.
What do you say, fellas? You want to team up?
I was thinking a 60-40 split.
Going my way, of course.
Do not shoot her.
Please?
No.
What the actual fuck?
We're a team. The three of us. Go grab some bounties.
Please, I just want to kill her a little bit.
God damn it, Spike. It's Jamie.
Or bad guys.
Depends on who you ask.
Hey. All right. There's a lot I saw there. All right. So we already saw this bit here. Yeah, Anna. What is that? I go by the name Spike Spiegel these days. Wasn't that Reggie's name? Wasn't that always his name? Like, why would he say that? I'm super confused why they would add that line in. That is his name, right? That is his name. Spike Spiegel. Original name. It's his original name. Why would they say that? Yeah, criminal wrestling code, blah, 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 blah. So, anyway.
So, I go by Spike Spiegel these days.
What was the next thing I saw? Where the hell is Ed throughout this whole thing? Is Ed not in this? It says beware of the dog on a sticker. Which means Iron is in it. We've already seen Iron. But where's Ed? Is Ed not in this at all? So Iron is pretty much just like an attraction for people to be like, oh my god, so cute. Oh my god, I can't wait to see the dog. But where's Ed? You know, where's the hacking? You know, the funny little intakes and stuff. You know, the teeter totter, teeter totter. Where's all that stuff? Like, I'm so confused. Why would they not throw Ed in there? It's like, she was one of the main people. She helped in so many things, you know? So there's the Rhino 60DS. Is that what it says? That I saw earlier? That's Jet's weapon that he uses for some reason, which he shouldn't be using. Confusing as fuck. That's supposed to be Teddy Bomb, I think.
Spoken like a man who...
This woman's supposed to be Spanish, but she's got a British accent. She's beautiful though, but...
Man who's never been in love.
I don't understand.
I was.
What happened?
I was dreaming.
I can't tell when you're joking and when you're not.
Yeah. I think that's supposed to be Akeem from the second episode.
You want to team up?
I remember her being strapped to a toilet. The first time they met.
At least uncup one hand. I can't even go to the bathroom this way.
So that's interesting.
I was thinking a 60-40 split.
And I never seen her steal his.
Do not shoot her.
And I'm not really sure. Oh, there's the Jericho knife. But I don't ever remember Spike threatening to kill a woman or even injure one. I'm trying to think, like, throughout all the episodes, I don't think I've ever seen him hit a woman or even try and threaten a woman with a gun. Especially, like, yeah, he doesn't like Faye, but I don't think he's ever attacked her. Ever.
Please?
No.
Alpha catch, I guess. That looks fucking weird as shit.
What the actual fuck?
Never heard Spike argue either. Never seen them two fight like that.
The three of us. Go grab some bounties.
I've never seen this shit.
Jeez, I just want to kill her a little bit.
God damn it, Spike.
It's jam.
See, like, I remember in the when Faye was introduced, she said that Spike was a gouger and she was a... Fuck, she says she's a Romany. And he's like, Romany. No, he goes, gouger. I like that, you know? And he there in the toilet, he's like, come on, Jet, let's go. And then they walk away and then she's there screaming and shit. And Ayn is just like howling.
We're Romanys. For eons, we've wandered the stars looking for love. It's our way.
Huh?
You don't know anything, do you? Romanys are gypsies. And you know what we call someone like you? A gaujo. That means a bumpkin who doesn't know which way is up.
Gaujo. I like that.
Oh, the wilds are calling me. You can't keep me locked up.
And then she must fly off in the ship, her ship, out of the bunker. And then she goes to him, gaujo. And he's like, Romany.
Hey, gaujo.
Hello, Romany.
I think that's the only freaking time they've had any kind of, you know, but it's not like malicious. It's just, it's not that deep. This here, I have no idea what's going on. I'm guessing this is the first episode as well. That's not the Jericho. I think during this scene, he has Jericho in his hand. When he's fighting Vicious in the church. He has the Jericho in his hand, and it's not like this. He runs up the stairs, and he gets attacked straight away. And then you got that scene. I don't know what this is. It's going to be interesting, nonetheless. There's just some weird changes that they made. I think that's... What's her name? What was her name? What's her name? Fuck. What was that lady's name? I can't remember her name, y'all. I had it. I lost it. At the end of the day, I don't know. I'm not too sure, man. I will have to wait and see how it goes. But personally, like, there's some weird changes to it that I've noticed. Just looking at it, I was like, what is going on here? This is a bit off. Like, some things are off and it feels a bit forced. but we'll see how it goes. I feel like if it was anything other than Cowboy Bebop, it would be really good. But because people know what Cowboy Bebop is like, they're stuck on old ways, and that's my brain. I would need a lot to change it. I'll probably have to watch it like 5 times just to change my mind, you know what I'm saying? But I don't know. In conclusion, it looks like they put a lot of work in. My guy John here, he seems to be putting a bit too much effort in. Like, if he just relaxed a bit more and he was just like, you know, it's like if he just chilled just a bit more, it would be a better performance. But like I said, it hasn't come out yet, so we'll have to see. Yo, I need to find out that woman's name. It's getting on my nerves. Anna Burdock? Anna? Not Burdock. What's her name? Maria Murdoch. Maria Murdoch, not Anna Burdock. When I say Anna Burdock, Maria Murdoch. Now I remember. I think that woman was Maria Murdoch. Anyway. Guys, this has been a long-ass video. I've been talking, like, a lot of crap. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Sorry if I'm very biased right now. We'll see. I might make another video later on, maybe on the first episode, and I'll explain how I feel about it. But from those two trailers, I don't know how I feel, to be honest. I'm kind of like 50-50. Well, I'm more 60-40 hate, not gonna lie to you. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I've been Vin6Many, and you guys have been amazing. Peace.